It's in your blood. Your instincts.
Potatoes aren't real. Woo! What up? Hello? Bro? Uh-oh. We don't have Justin as a caster. Where's Olive? We want Olive! We want Olive! We want Olive! We want Olive!
There. Okay. Now you can hear me. We are live. Okay. Let's see. Do they have... Yeah, I do, actually. Hold on. Let me get that to you. Zoop, zoop, zoop. All right, we're gonna start up the pick bands here. These are on the wrong side.
This is Juice Me Famory versus Potatoes Are Unreal, right?
Yes. So Juice Me Famory starting blue side, Potatoes Aren't Real on red side. Starting pick bands.
I really is Zerath. I really obviously for Jaundice and Zerath as well for Simply Phenomenal. Both. Champions these two play frequently.
Yeah, Simply Phenomenal, really well known for Azerath. He played a lot of it. Slatting Up Magoos. That's what it was.
Yeah, that's right. Played a lot of it last season too on whatever that team was.
We've been at this for so long, I forget.
Too many seasons. Too many small tournaments. Lulu ban. I assume that's against Juice Me Hoagie, as well as any other potential supports that could be there, but most likely Juice Me Hoagie. Jarvan, another one that Sarah Cruz did play last week, also could be a top lane ban too, because after that buff, he's pretty good in top lane.
Yeah, Jarvan, I think, really, really good right now. Sarah Cruz popped off on it last week against my team, so that was fun to deal with.
We need to prioritize the first pick. We know Hoagie doesn't usually play a lot of tanks. I was going to say Alistar is really, really good. Pretty much like a number one tank support.
Yeah.
Especially with Nurse coming in, Rakan and Braum. Could maybe see something like a Kai'Sa, or just a priority, or a misfortune.
Okay.
I feel like that's so risky, just a first pick. But you know, obviously, PMALCS history would show that misfortune's win rate is just crazy.
It's super
pick
strong
and win
for us.
Rate in the league is just super high.
Yeah. I like it.
Yeah, it could be worse.
And there's the Alistar.
Yep. Yep, and a Kali as well.
Really
want to
get on
that
misfortune.
I could go Nukapaturk. I said that he likes his Akali, so.
That is if they send Nukapaturk to the bot lane as support. He has been playing mid.
Maybe it's a top lane pick?
I don't know.
Who knows? It could be flexed either way. Akali kind of being able to do whatever you need her to do. As we see a Morgana here coming out as an answer to this Alistar, most likely. Would make sense as it's kind of something that hero can play that is a good counter, and it does get locked in, so we do see the misfortune Morgana bottom lane. Maybe we see a mid lane pick here, seeing as the Akali's already been picked. Could also be Morgana mid, the flex, but most likely going to be support.
Yeah, Morgana, another one of those champs that has a history of a history of being really, really good in the PMA LCS. And the Melzahar coming out for Juice Me Famory. I wonder if...
Yeah, that should be... It's not bad against Akali. Akali still has the advantage because she's got shorter cooldowns and the ability to kind of burst through Melzahar in a 1v1. But if you can get Melzahar ahead early on, it's kind of hard to deal with.
I think that's where Simply Phenomenal I think that's a pretty good pickup for them,
Oh,
especially against the
Lucian
Mercari.
Alistar. Good. That's a strong bottom lane there. As we haven't seen any jungler yet, so I assume we'll see a couple of jungle bans thrown out here. I don't know, because both these junglers are pretty flexible with what they could play, but I imagine that is what we'll kind of see from here. Aatrox, actually a top lane ban, another one against Daddy. I don't even know, does he play the new Aatrox?
Juice Me Daddy? Yes, he has. He plays that
Surprised, I know
quite a
he
bit.
openly has stated he misses the old
Oh,
Aatrox.
I know he misses the old Aatrox.
Old Aatrox was so dumb,
But
though.
I do know that Juice Me Daddy does actually kind of like the new Aatrox. I think he's grown accustomed to it.
It makes sense. As we see, no ban coming out.
That was a Jax ban, they said in chat.
Okay, that makes sense. More top laners, so my guess about junglers was a little bit off. But like I said, it's a top jungle ban.
Yeah.
Actually, primarily a jungle. But if you want to look at it, the top lane, three top lane bans with an Ornn being the next one as well.
Oh, we know that Juice Me Daddy plays that.
Yeah, we do.
Oh,
Kind of
man.
curious what he's got left in the pool here to kind of bring out. And there's a jungle ban.
I don't know what Juice Me Daddy has in the top lane. He can really play anything up there.
Yeah, I think it'll be all right. We still haven't seen a Sion. I would not be surprised if they went ahead and picked
Ooh,
the
that'd be a
Sion right here.
spicy pick.
Pretty much the best top lane tank you can have.
He
It's a
he's been
pretty
in a good
safe
spot
blind
for a
pick.
while, yeah.
Yeah, he's just tough to deal with. He gets so tanky early on, especially with his W, the passive on his W. But they are gonna take the priority jungler, opting for that Graves. That's a good pick.
That's going to Syracuse, most likely.
So I guess the advantage now is you can save the Akali, kind of like to flex if they need to for the last pick. Worst comes to worst, they could send the Akali top if they need to, or they could. And the Zac, that would be interesting.
Is that gonna be for Juice Me Mommy in the jungle?
I guess so. I don't really like the Zac combination with Misfortune, just because I feel like 99.9% of the time, what Zac wants to do is jump in, grab two people, and bring them out.
Yeah.
But what Misfortune wants you to do is just hold them still. So, they'll have to be careful with that combination. Make sure that, Morgana or Malzahar are leading the engages, and Zac's kind of just the follow-up. Or vice versa.
Good
And
kick.
a McCoy!
McCoy.
McCoy. Top lane. So that's two tanky, two very tanky top side there. So that does show that the Alistar is going to be excuse me, the Akali is going to be most likely mid. I assume they'll go with the tank. Probably Sion here to match. But we will see what they opt into as they opt into pick. Yeah, there it is.
Hey, you called it.
So it does look like it is going to be a Sion Maokai matchup. Malzahar, Akali mid. So pretty strong dominant laners from both sides. I was watching one of my students was doing an ARAM earlier. It was a 40-minute ARAM. And he was playing Maokai. And every time he would heal for like 600. It was ridiculous.
Oh man.
It was so stupid. Because it was like late game and so many spells were being used, so. Maokai, not really picked that much anymore, but very underrated. Just a point and click snare
Yeah, just
and
the
the ability to
lockdown that
follow up.
he has, and like, yeah, the point and click
Right.
snare, it's he's almost too safe, and really good synergy with the Misfortune.
Yeah, that's true. See, again, they just have to be careful with the Zac to make sure that they're tossing people out, from where they're supposed to be. But yeah, it is really, a lot of point and click. Malzahar, Maokai combination, and then Morgana follow up. It's a really strong team right there. I feel like the side of Potato Jar and Real also have a strong team. I feel like theirs is a little tougher to pull off. Kind of have to rely on the Sion engages or the Alistar engages, kind of just to lead the front. Obviously, the side of Juice Me Famary is kind of straightforward, their plan.
to set up the misfortune ult.
Right, right. But if they are able to get the Sakali roll, then nothing beats her, so.
They might have to pay the tax with some QSSs on the side of Par. With the Melzahar tax, with the Morgana binding, and the Baokai, as well as the Zac. It's just a lot of lockdown.
Oh yeah, I would honestly, especially because, especially on maybe a Collier, or even Lucian, if you can get ahead, just having a QSS against Malzahar specifically, not even including the Morgana or Maokai, but specifically against Malzahar is really the biggest counter to him. He can't really do much once you get the QSS. Can't believe it's October, man. September flu.
Remember, kids, your rent is due.
Yep. Yep. Sad days. we just PMALCS covers everyone's rent for 1 month.
Oh, please.
We have the funds to do that. Totally.
I don't think.
Are we gonna be hearing extra commentary from the bird tonight?
The bird? No, he's asleep.
Aww.
I mean, unless he decides to squawk out, but.
I'm sure he'll make his presence known at some point.
It's past his bedtime.
Yeah, he's tired. He's had a long day of watching Justin carry us.
I don't know about that. I think my entire team inted game 2 this afternoon.
What new Kappa Turk? Why?
What just happened?
Why you do
oh,
this?
Oh no. Oh, that feels bad.
Feels bad. Now we got our remix. It's alright, it happens.
His comp crashed. Oof.
All of purple says it's past your bedtime, Justin.
It is past my bedtime. I work tomorrow morning.
She says it's 2 minutes late. It's okay, we got you all.
Oh my god.
We're still on point here. You're the only one in chat, so we got you here. Support you. You're all about our jokes.
This is going swimmingly.
Yeah, looks like we're having some lobby issues here. As we are.
What?
What? What? What is going on?
What's happening?
Do you see that?
What the heck is going on?
The lobby like restarted itself with the characters in it. That was so weird.
Oh my god. I'm kind of scared. Oh, we got some bits. I'm not in my live
party bits.
Hold on. Who's bidding right now? Olive Purple tier 10 bits. Hey, you're number one, I think. I'm not sure.
Oh, they need to remake the lobby.
Oh, that feels bad.
And it sounds like we're already off to a normal PMALCS game. As we have to remake the lobby.
Both teams lose a ban, right? It's after 10 minutes.
Yeah, let's talk about how cool that Rise music video is, though.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
so
that was so hype.
Good, dude. And like even the animations and everything, they're just so cool.
Yeah, Riot's been doing really good with those animated shorts recently. Like anything that comes out that's animated is just.
I'm hoping they just like eventually come out with a legit show for League of Legends.
That'd be cool. That would be really
cool.
It'd
be so cool.
Or can you imagine like a JRPG?
Yeah, that would be so cool. I would watch that. I would watch that.
Oh man.
Well, who knows? I mean, with their new game coming out next year, I assume we'll see a lot more cinematics for it.
Yeah.
I'm curious if they'll reuse their lead characters. I imagine they will.
I would assume so. Maybe the same
like
thing
that,
like Heroes of
like
Storm and
to get people to play it because people will be like, oh, I get to play Zoe in another game. That's awesome.
Yeah, that's not this toxic game.
Yeah. Jeez. I don't know. Battle Royale, League of Legends.
Oh god. It's bound to happen. I'm playing a meme song.
So many Battle Royale games nowadays, man. Like, the new Call of Duty and Battlefield both have Battlewood.
God, dude, I know, like, I liked it when it was becoming popular, and now it's just overdone.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree.
I still play PUBG every now and again.
Yeah, see, the one thing I don't like about... Fortnite's okay, but the one thing I don't like about PUBG is, like, you could just play a game for, like, 20 minutes, and then just randomly get killed by a camper, and that's it.
That's accurate. That's so true.
There's some dude that posted on Reddit today that he made a... Battle Royale where the rounds are over in 5 minutes. It's like a 2D kind of, you know, down or up down kind of view. It looks pretty cool.
Oh, okay.
I think that's kind of, that would be kind of almost the future of Battle Royale. It's just faster rounds. See, I think, well, Realm Royale is like League of Legends character, but Battle Royale, I believe.
Okay.
Something like that. So I think that would be pretty cool.
Yeah.
Imagine that, like, having a. Having different abilities on your characters, that'd be cool.
That'd be interesting. I don't know, I think it would be interesting. I'd probably try it out if that did, like, be a thing. But I think we're just so used to, like, you know, the third person, first person shooter, ground or else that, you know, a company's been pumping out left and right.
Who dares defy my will?
Yeah, I think that's kind of the one thing that Fortnite did right, is the fact that their game was free. So, you know, I mean, if you think about it, like, you can literally, like, you can be in a group of people and have play on your phone, your Switch, your PS4, your Xbox, your computer, anything. You can just all play together.
Yeah,
that's
so cool.
It really is. I honestly think that's the future of gaming. Just being able to play with any of your friends anytime, anywhere.
Yeah, we finally got that win in 2018. Not even 2019.
Yeah, I know, right? I don't know where it'll go from here. I'm honestly surprised Minecraft didn't happen first, but I think that's because it's owned by Microsoft. That's why it didn't.
Mm-hmm.
I'm curious to, like, know what the next game will be that will be cross everything, especially cross mobile, which is kind of crazy. We'll see. All that matters is that in 6 days, Mario Party comes out.
Ooh.
And in 2 months, Smash comes out.
Yeah. I didn't know about the Mario Party, but I definitely know about Smash. I've been following that.
I can't wait. Do you have a Switch?
Yes, I do.
Oh, nice. Oh yeah, that's right. We talked about this.
Yeah, we're going to play Mario Party.
Fear the shadows.
Oh, yeah. Are you going to get Mario Party?
Probably.
Oh, yeah. That would be so much fun. One Mario Party kind of parties. The only sucky part is that you cannot play online regular Mario Party together.
Really?
Because it's just two mini games.
Oh.
Isn't that stupid?
Yeah, that. Okay. That's a little
upsetting. That's like a Nintendo thing to do, you know?
Yeah. That's always really upsetting. Oh, man.
Yeah. That's like releasing Splatoon 2, but having no way to, like, queue with your.
Oh, well. But, I was gonna say, if we could do, like, some Mario Party, I can stream that.
Oh, we'll do some stuff.
Yeah, we will.
We'll settle pick band discrepancies and subbing discrepancies via Mario Party.
Brontosaurus, John. Sorry. Yeah, John. Jaundice. Yeah. Best name. I don't know.
That's okay.
I always call him Juan Dick 3.
Juan Dick 3. I think the best name is got to go to your boy, Mr. Buttersworth.
God. So, fun story about that name. I was drunk one night playing with Sebastian, Uncle Jemima. And I said, you know what? If I draft you for Frog Brawl, I'm going to change my name to Mr. Buttersworth because his name was Uncle Jemima. I'm like, hey, that fits. Lo and behold, it gets the fifth round and he's unpicked still. I'm like, I need a top laner. So I pick up Sebastian. I pick up Uncle Jemima. I make the group chat, like, I completely forgot about it at this point. Make the group chat, and first thing he says, you know what you have to do to your name now, right? Like, oh, shoot, I did promise that.
You're like, yeah.
As much as I love Taboy.
That was a great name, though.
I mean, I'm gonna change it back after this split, but I think Mr. Buttersworth is fun for the team.
That's cheating.
What do you mean it's cheating?
All right, chat. Let's get your opinions. Should he be hashtag Jaboy or hashtag Mr. Buttersworth?
We'll let you Buttersworth.
Yeah, hashtag Buttersworth or hashtag Jaboy. Let us know what you think. What does Olive think? I'm curious.
What do you think, Olivia?
Boy formerly known as Chuck.
Alright, I like that. Rename yourself to Chuck.
Chuck? Wait, T-Z-Y-A-K?
No, I said Chuck.
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 Oh, man. That's one thing that I've always enjoyed about the PMA LCS. As I know others have not enjoyed, but I personally love is the name swapping for teams and stuff like that.
Yeah, it's kind of cool. I mean, a lot of the stuff that we have is really inside, like, almost how you say. Like, you know, in any other league, I don't think there'd be that many name swaps. How do I want to put this? You know, there wouldn't be that many name swaps if people like their names or something.
Yeah, that's true.
But we do everything for the meme here. Like, find me off.
As an example, Chris changes his name to Chad Penguin, but then someone steals Mouse Cop.
Yeah, that felt bad. I almost felt really bad for him because I was surprised he even got Mouse Cop. That's a pretty popular name, obviously, from the Key and Peele sketch.
Right. Yeah, I guess kind of just got lucky with it. I feel like the person who took it was definitely a Siphonian, though.
Yeah.
Who knows? As we're about to get into this game here after half an hour.
Oh. Not time.
It wouldn't be PMA LCS if we started on time.
All right. I'm hyped for this game.
Me too.
So, this one actually has a lot of. What am I gonna say? So it affects the outcome of. Cause this. Oh my gosh, I can't talk. So this is the last match in.
Oh,
the Chadswick division. So this will determine first and second. Well, it will determine everything. If Par goes 2-0, they clinch first seed in the division. If they go 1-1, then it's a tiebreaker between the Breakfast Club and Par, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay.
I'd have to look that up.
So there's still potential all over the place.
Yeah.
Alright, well, that's interesting. Keeps things fresh. That means this game has a lot of importance.
The names. Alright.
As we are going to load in here, with the world's banner icons in the back, I have to move these people around here a little bit. Move you up to there, move you down to there.
So blue side is blue. And red side is Par.
There's Lightpulse 94 saying, "Let's go re." You hate to see that moderator collusion in the league. Unfortunate that we have to put up with this unbearable collusion of the moderators, but I guess it is what it is.
I think he's rooting for re because if re goes 2-0, then his team, the Breakfast Club, actually clinches first.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I say his team. It's also my team.
the team.
I'm trying to be as unopposed to both as I can.
Unbiased, unbiased, our moderator.
Yeah.
All purple. Bitch, I'm a cow. Bitch, I'm a cow. Oh, Jesus. Bitch, I'm a cow. I don't say meow.
Wait, is that
Olivia? Moo, moo, moo. I ain't in the mood, bitch, I'm too smooth. Used the wrong form of two. All of her arguments are now invalidated.
All right.
You hate to see that in today's world.
So, looks like we have not standard.
Oh, we saw that. We saw that, Kami. And the Mia Ping's coming out. unfortunate timing. Lag.
That's probably what he's doing. So not quite standard starts. Grave's going. Did he start chickens first? No, he started red.
As we are just gonna see the normal tank top lane.
Call it a wet noodle fight. Nobody's built damage yet. It's a wet noodle fight.
A wet noodle fight. Yes. Oh, I gotta move. Misfortune 2v8 carry. There we go. Something to note, Bakugan something for the minion dematerializer. A very common start against two range. As we do see the engage from an Alistar with the level 2. So a good amount of damage come out as well as Jaundice. But here comes Seracruz moving up for the gank. As we're gonna see Twisted Advance from Juice Me Daddy. Just gonna escape out of that one. I didn't even notice that it was Juice Me Hoagie on AD carry.
Yeah, he picked up the Misfortune for this game. And put...
Well, she's such a high skill champion to play. Lag.
I'm surprised there's no missing MIA picked up for that one.
New Kapaturk is going to be aggressive here. Everyone knowing Akali is a stupid champion that nobody enjoys playing against. Bride's like, let's rework stealth, but make one character that defeats our entire stealth.
Yeah, I didn't quite get that. I think she's really strong, but it seems like people are learning how to play against her.
Are they though?
For the most part.
Are they just banning her?
I mean,
is that how you play against her though?
Yeah, you just ban her. So we see a lot of scrap going along all around the map, it looks like.
Yeah, pretty kind of calm game so far. Obviously we did see a little bit of fighting between Zach and or Juice Me Mom against Seracruz by that scuttle, but other than that, not really much going on. I see a little bit of a farm lead accumulating mid and bottom lane here for the side of Potatoes Aren't Real. But nothing too crazy, still manageable, but it is about a wave though, so... As we do see the Q damage here from John is actually chunking down Juice Me Daddy. As I see a headbutt, Pogrest come in, the Black Shield's gonna come down, but they're gonna try to do what they can. Midoriya flashes in, the heal's gonna be used, a couple of auto attacks coming, but not gonna be able to pick up the kill as they are going to burn the flash the flash and the heal and exhaust from the side of Famory.
Yeah, pretty good.
First blood for Midoriya. As
we see a bit of
they're still trying to chase. Wow, getting a lot of damage here. They have to get under the turret. Keep in mind they have no exhaust as John is looking to potentially dive. Here comes the decimating strike and the W explosion. So a second kill here. Four Potatoes Aren't Real. One on their AD carry and one on their top laner.
Yeah, that was a very, very well executed dive by Jaundice there. Like, he had, what do you call it, the decimating carry? His, the shield little pop thing. He had that going into the dive. He knew he had enough damage to, if he get the Q off, and get out of there alive. Like, that Scion poke coming in, huge, early game.
Yeah, he played it really well, you know, not taking early turret aggro there. And we do see as a result of that, and the 5-minute Infernal Dragon picked up here. So already a 1.1k lead, 1.1k gold lead here, and an Infernal Dragon, so a really nice start for Potatoes Aren't Real. Oh, here comes the dive! Level 6! New Kapaturk's trying to do what he can, is it gonna be enough?
Ignite? Oh, it's like enough!
And the ignite and a stack there on the Dark Seal. So three kills now for the side of Pandas Aren't Real. A dominant early game so far.
Yeah, all over the map too. We got a kill on all the laners.
Oh, decimating strike. Not gonna actually. The twisted advance gonna be used to stop it. Excuse me, Daddy. Actually coming out on top of that one. But did have to use a good chunk of his mana. Also, Jaundice does have TP, so all of these trades are really not advantageous for Juice Me Daddy because he's just gonna have to kind of back out anyway once Jaundice TP's in.
I like that top lane. I like that matchup. It's just super scrappy both ways.
It is. They're like tanks, but they're tanks that like to trade in lane.
Oh. That's some damage.
That's some double up damage. He did go up to go with the misfortune as well, so. Or double tap, excuse me.
Wait, did he call it damage? Oh, he had Dark Seal and Hextech. What do you call that? Is it Revolver?
Yeah, that Akali is going to start to really pump out the deeps. As Jaundice letting another decimating strike, still following up here. Juice Me Daddy's going to go over here. Back, Bakugan is gonna knock him up. The 1Q is in a pullback here, an unbelievable pullback, picking up the kill on the Midoriya. Bakugan just gonna flash away, or Bakugo, excuse me, just gonna flash away. So, nice gank by Juice Me Mommy to kind of bring one back for his team.
Yeah, and very, very good follow up by Juice Me Kami. That Q almost max range on Midoriya. Oh, jeez. Midoriya-kun, there it is.
Just call him Deku.
Deku.
Deku! I watched this video earlier today. It was like, Deku can't do anything without Bakugo yelling. And it was like him sitting homework, and he's like, Deku, are you doing homework? Oh, as we are going to see the ultimate from Maokai having to come out just to escape this invade here by Seracruz. So, in the end, and nothing coming of it, but a disengage.
Yeah, that is a Maokai ult down. If they decide to try something top lane, he doesn't really have that escape. Or if he wants to make a teleport play, they won't have that that follow-up rut. I'd say worth for par on that in bed.
Oh yeah, for sure. Especially because Jaundice still has TP, so he has the advantage here. As we do see the junglers, or Seracruz mainly just taking the blue. Juicy Mommy looks like he may be a little caught out as we see the headbutt. Now, the stun is up. Zach is gonna go down as he flashes, but it's not gonna be enough. The passing is gonna come up. Let's see who they give this kill to. Oh, the TP is gonna go for Juicy Mommy. Oh, excuse me, but Simply Phenomenal. Bullet time's gonna come, but it's not gonna land on anybody. The TP goes through, but Simply Phenomenal just simply does not have enough mana. As the Doria Kun is gonna pick up a kill for himself. They're still trying to chase. New Kappa Turk's gonna get one here. Alistar does go down, but this could be the end of Juice Me Hoagie as well. Flash again, healing away. New Kappa Turk is chasing. Lands the ultimate, does get the procs to follow. So very, very nice job there by New Kappa Turk, getting all of that damage right there and following up to pick up 3 kills total.
I like the teleport play to try to save the Zac there, but I just don't know if that was worse. I know Hoagie threw out his ultimate, but Kami missed the Q, so they were just able to walk away from that and I guess pick up 3 kills in the process.
Oh, a nice dodge there by the Zac. As we do see another headbutt, Pulverize coming. Character is following the damage. Juice Me Kami going to use the stopwatch, going to live actually. But nothing gonna come of that except the stopwatch burn. I think the TP, the idea of it was good. He just didn't have the mana to follow up. So he TP'd in and essentially just gave away a free kill because he just didn't have much, anything to kind of do once he was there.
Yeah, you have to be
so
aware of that.
In the end, he burned his TP and they gave up 2 kills. Should have just let him die and kind of moved on from there. As we see the wet noodle fight continuing to go on. Violet Sociocat, I am also not a huge Poly specifically. The health from Doran's is surprisingly meaningful. I would probably agree with that. Especially early on. I mean, you're not really going to be getting many early kills here against Akali to justify the Dark Seal. And now that Akali has been able to get ahead, it's really going to be tough to deal with her. I mean, she is going to be a huge threat in all these fights.
We see Akali with 3 kills.
Oh!
Okay.
All right.
And that was that. I was going to say, if you had 3 kills.
But I don't know if I'd call it an onslaught.
Okay.
More like an off slot, am I right? Cricket.
Chirp.
Seracruz looks to be getting a gank off mid. There is a ward in that side bush, so Simply Phenomenal is gonna know. Ping's coming down, alerting his presence to the rest of the team.
Yeah, CM Park's probably gonna look for this second Infernal Drake.
I don't even think they have much to contest with it. I think they're just going to get it for free. As here comes Akali, and... We'll just leave it at that, and here we go. The follow-up's still coming out. Some Q damage here. Lucian is going to go in. Oh, a flash away from Juice Mikami. Going to be able to live. Here comes the calling. Going to pick up a kill for the side of Midoriya. The flash. Flash Q's not going to land. He's going to get rooted and actually give up a kill here to the Morgana. But on the same way, Midoriya picking up another kill. 4-1 Lucian right now. So in the end, an Infernal Dragon and 2 kills here for the side of Potato's Iron Wheel.
Yeah, they're just starting to run away with this. Oh.
Oof. Yeah.
Stood up 4K, over 4K. That's first tower going down. They have 2 Infernal Drakes. If they play this right, this can end super early. I don't know if they want really to scale. I mean, not really team fighting that.
Honestly, I don't even know if they can scale at this point. Akali taking over the ultimate from Malice, but it's gonna be new cap of Turk kind of just playing havoc, and here comes no landing there from that flash from Jaundice, and the shield actually gonna come from his W to save him from the space aids. As they're still trying to do what they can here from the side of Juice Me Famory, but it's really not looking good early on. Down about 5k gold as well as 2 infernals.
I agree.
Hoki and Kami, I did think, played that bottom lane well, for what it's worth. I mean, so far. But yeah, I agree. The double inferno and a 10 stack. Polly, it's just gonna be. I mean, she already has her Gunblade finished, and it's only 14 minutes in, so it's gonna be really, really tough to deal with her. I bet she's sitting on 2k gold too, so when she backs, that's gonna be upgraded boots and, you know, kind of whatever she wants to go from there.
All right.
As it does look like Juice Me Daddy and Juice Me Hokey are up here together, so not a full on lane swap. Maybe Juice Me Daddy backs off and obviously give it up, as the binding is gonna land, the silence is gonna come out. Here comes a nice try, burning the flash of Akali. Nice try by Juice Me Mommy, trying to get a little kind of cheeky play. As Juice Me Daddy is looking for the engage, gets a twisted advance into the bullet time. Very, very nice try. The silence is gonna come out, but the glass code is gonna save the 3 members of them. A very, very nice try there from Juice Me Daddy and Juice Me Hokey.
And that's exactly. It's exactly what they want to do. They want to set up the MF ult. It's gonna do a lot of damage whether she's behind or not. If they can get some plays like that, they are not out of this.
Yeah, I agree. They have to make those plays though. Unfortunate just that black. But they need to start making something happening. As Juice Mami looks like he has met the end of his days. Another kill here for New Captain Turk. Gonna be another stack on the Dark Seal. Wait. Yep. Oh, excuse me. It's already max Dark Seal, so not another stack. Just another kill. As looks like two members here, Midoriya and Jaundice, just going to leave. A couple of low people here from Reeb, but not able to pick them up as they are just going to back out. And they are opting to completely leave here. I think they know the Scion Ultimate isn't up because they are just giving that tower up for free, respecting the Scion damage.
And nobody that was up there had enough mana to really do anything. And the only person with enough mana to really lay out any abilities was the Misfortune, and she was super low health. Plus, they might have seen the Akali rune.
Oh my gosh, that damage! Oh my god. Oh my gosh.
Looks like Akali's going Seekers. Probably gonna go into a Zonya's. That's the word.
Yeah, most likely. Kind of at this point, just to get something to kind of, get a little bit more survivability. Vod Celestial can also say, surprise Akali did go Seekers, or went Seekers instead of QSS. Yeah, I think that does attribute to the fact that he's just ahead. The QSS would be nice, but like, you're just not even gonna take a lot of damage from the battles. It probably will be the next item, I imagine, just kind of being able to counter that mouse. But, interesting that the Seekers is that first pick there, especially because there isn't really a ton of AD damage. I guess the only thing they're really worried about is the bullet time. It does do a lot when they're able to land the combination together.
Yeah, and Azonius can completely negate that if she gets caught in it.
Yeah, for sure. As we do see the bullet time combination, they're trying to do it. They can't do the bomber, but they're just too far behind. Actually, New Capitol's going to be stopped. Actually, going to give up a kill. After getting the triple kill, Bakugan gonna go down as well. They are gonna dive. They are gonna pick up an ace here for the side of Potatoes Aren't Real. A shutdown coming down, 850 gold over to this Malzahar. So at least that's something to help them out a little bit, but they are gonna get a tower and an ace. A very, very nice dive there. Unfortunately losing two, but still a great dive for them.
Yeah, that Akali just put in so much damage that fight. I know she went down, gave over the gold, what are you?
Not bad with words.
Shutdown gold, but it's almost worth it. We got the ace. We got a lot. Really got a lot off of that. You got the ace. You got the tower. Violet Sosu can't really.
That health back that New Kappa Turk got back was just unreal. Just, man, the Akali things are just crazy. Especially with the having the Hextech Gunblade passive for the 50% damage dealt back, and it being AoE, not including all of his abilities that are already AoE. Just crazy DPS, and they need to have an answer for him. No magic resistance yet. From anybody, actually, as it looks like Juice Me Daddy is opting to go with Sunfire Cape first, and it looks like Righteous Glory in the jungle. So no magic resistance yet. So that Akali damage is just gonna keep being stronger and stronger. Juice Me Daddy trying to take a little bit of trades here. Actually, Jaundice doesn't have a lot of mana, but he is. The blue buff does go to the Akali. Nice try there. Twisted Advance gonna go in. Juice Me Daddy actually might get this one here. The sapling damage. Actually, no. Juice Me Daddy is just so far ahead. Jaundice is just so far ahead. He does get the armor reduction from his E. Decimating Strike not going to land on anybody. Just gonna try to push this wave in and pick up a tower as the rest of his team. Oh, but here comes Juice Me Kami. Oh! Tickles his butt cheeks. Here's Midoriya, Deku, United States of Smash, here it comes, as the binding is gonna, the headbutt pulverize combo actually gonna stop the bullet time, but nothing's gonna come from it. And here comes the ultimate use on the Scion, nothing's gonna come to that either, but Zac is going with a three-man ulti, picking up a double kill, an unbelievable ultimate here. Jaundice is dead now. Tommy, with Neil Capaturk pushing top, they found their chance to engage, and they went for it.
Yeah, that's huge for Juice Me Famery. With the collie completely out of the equation, they had a huge engage. They got three kills off of bringing them somewhat back into this game any way they can.
Yeah, I think at that point they needed to just... That was the right play for Graves, picking up himself. But they had to give up the top tower and try to do what they can to pick up some kills. Just being so far down, a big fight like that was what they really needed to kind of do anything they can to stay in this game. Let's get a big juice there. some juicy big juice. Nice play by Juice Me Bobby.
Now, I'm surprised that turned out that well for them. I think Bakugo on the Alistar disrupting the bullet time coming through. I didn't think they would have enough damage to cut through everybody, but they came out with three kills. It was very, very well played.
Yeah, I think it was a little bit of a misplay as well from the side of the potatoes aren't real. Bakugo actually going in to dive a little bit, getting hit by the binding, I believe, under the tower, so he got killed. As we see, Seracruz doing a lot of damage, actually having to flash away when Juice Me Mommy does show up with Simply Phenomenal there showing up as well. So, putting out a lot of damage though early on with a Black Cleaver and his jungling item finished already. But again, at this point, Potatoes Are Unreal just need to really get a full-on team fight going. They either need to like group up and get a fight or get a collie in a side lane and just get her split pushing while the rest of them kind of manage. They tried to do that earlier, but unfortunately they tried to start a fight rather than just letting New Capitur kind of split push like he wants to. Because they don't have anyone that can answer him. Like, here's another situation. Is they send New Capitur bottom lane, definitely call. But now they really need to be careful. Top cannot get shot. They just have to be safe. As a binding does land on the Lucian, the point can be used. But Alistar's going to go in to stop it. Juice Me Kami's going to use the Sonya's. Here comes the Zac as well. Bakugo is going to go down. The flash ultimate's going to be used. Onto looks like Seracruz. He's going to go down as well with the silence. Shutdown. Juice Me Mommy is still going in with the jump. He does not land it onto Midoriya. The bind does land onto Jaundice, and they are knocking. Oh, they are going to get him with the Malzahar. Juice Me Hoagie going to flash in to pick it up. So, three more kills here picked up for Juice Me Bomberry as they're just not able to kind of work the split push as New Capiturk going in with the Akali things. Cannot be targeted by towers because Riot is a great gaming company that knows what this game needs best. As he is gonna... This is a very risky Baron. Oh my gosh, this is so risky.
Yeah, but they're not gonna be able to burn it down before the
no, they're not. And they're
Midori and
Bakugo. I don't even know if they'll be able to do it.
Get there. They're all low.
Oh, the headbutt pulverize coming in. Trying to do what he can. He does pick up a kill in the shutdown, actually. Midoriya's gonna follow. This could be devastating. This might actually... This is gonna be an in-hit for sure. It could be more if they're able to stop these backs. They're not. Oh, they are gonna pick up the Zac. They could go for a Baron now themselves. As the TP's coming in, they are just gonna try to end this game. As the ultimate... Oh, I think that was the ultimate. Excuse me. I don't think they're gonna be able to end it. The W coming in from Malcolm. New Capitur just dons the damage to Super Comp. Still trying to do what they can. Oh, a double ultimate kill, or a double ultimate pickup from Jaundice, and the Q, a double kill for Akali. That Q damage being unreal as she's looking for more. The full time's gonna come out under the tower. Actually gonna not pick up New Capitur. He is gonna go down right now, though. Wait, no, he's not.
Oh, no.
He's gonna win.
No.
Wait, he's got the W shield. Capiturk does get the killing back. He has to be careful because he's pretty low right now. He's gonna pick up a huge kill. New Capiturk putting out unbelievable damage as the rest of his team gets the Baron. So in the end, this is really what Potatoes Aren't Real we're trying to do. Oh, here's another one. Yep. But I mean this is how Potatoes Are Unreal just win this game. They just get a collie in a side lane and just no one can deal with her right now. You know, you just have the rest of your team kind of split. They tried to do that earlier. You know, I Deuce Mifamory had a really, really, really good engage on the top lane when they kind of picked him off when they knew the Akali was bottom lane. Where things went wrong is where they decided to go for that Baron.
And we see one magic resist item on the side of Ree. It is the Negatron Cloak on the Maokai. Juice me daddy.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. Merc Treads on the Zac.
Yep. We also see a 16th month tier 2 sub coming from none only Sayato. Look at me and love me, Greg. I do love you, Austin. I love you long time.
I love you more,
Austin.
You will
forever be not president. That was such a good team, man. We trolled a lot. We also had Max in our team, so, you know, it was kind of rough having to deal with him. No, I'm just kidding. It was a fun team. Just me, Mommy needs to be careful. He did just use his jump. Oh, as the headbutt is going to save us. Oh, wait. No, it is going to save his life. Having to ult out though, just in case, having that Lucian there, as they are gonna look to just push top and brute force this down. Akali also gonna split mid. This is a great, great split here for Potatoes on Real. Juice Me Daddy going in, the bullet time is gonna land, damage is coming down, it's just not enough to pick up any of these kills. Juice Me Kami going in with the ultimate, the Soul Shackles is not gonna pick up anybody. The Zone is actually calling, it's gonna take him down on the end of that engage. Here comes the engage from Zag. Gonna try to bring them in, brings two of them together, the team is trying to follow up, they just don't have the damage to finish off the kill.
Because they're calling the back line.
On the back line, trying to do what he can, as we do see a dive here from the side of Potatoes on Real, with the Akali, she's getting the execute damage. They do pick up an ace, and it looks like they're picking up game number one.
Very, very good 4-1 right there. That's the only person that you can't really deal with.
Once they started to kind of get the formula for the split pushing and not having the rest of the team kind of get picked off, it was kind of just that it, you know, that was it from there. They had nobody. Holly, kind of just showing how skilled that champion can be at, you know, if she's able to get ahead in the early game. A really, really, really great showing from New Kappa Turk. And Potatoes Are Unreal taking game number one. Do we even need to do an MVP poll?
Yeah.
I guess we'll do one anyway.
Let's, hold on. What do I want to do here? I'm going to go to there. I'm going to go to advanced details and show off these stats. Okay, so Akali doing a lot less damage than I expected to see. 27,000, I think the next one was actually the Misfortune, 23, almost 24. But yeah, just too much for Ree to handle.
So I think this kind of goes without question, but who do you think won MVP?
I don't know. I was thinking not the Akali. I don't think the Akali was good at all.
Yeah, I would agree. Not Akali. Anybody but the Akali. Let's give it to Caleb. I'm gonna give it to Caleb.
Yeah.
Congrats, Caleb. Your game on MVP.
Oh man. No, but real talk. That Akali, New Kappa Turk's Akali was just disgusting, and it was so enabling, like. As soon as he got ahead, they had to focus on that, and his team was able to get other things done. Granted, there were some team fights where New Kappa Turk wasn't around, and they got some comeback kills. But in the end, it was like the damage on top of not really that much magic resist spelled just destruction.
Yeah, and you know, and especially because the Akali was picked, and then they kind of went the Malzahar to counter it. Like I said at the beginning of the game, Malzahar, I just don't think he's really that much of a counter to Akali. Maybe something like the Galio might have been better. I think Simply Phenomenal plays it. But again, it's just a tough matchup to play it too, especially when he gets an early kill in lane. But I think we are going to take a minute or two break here while we get set up for game number two. Hopefully, it doesn't take a half hour to get the lobby going this time.
Oh, God.
So stay tuned, and we will be right back.